In this video, I would like to show how we can use the TinySA to do a quick assessment of a amplifier for a broadband magnetic loop. This amplifier is specifically designed for the very low output impedance of the broadband magnetic loop, so you can't provide an input signal or easily provide an input signal to the amplifier using a normal signal generator that you directly connect to the input of the amplifier. The amplifier is matched to the loop, the magnetic loop. So in this setup, we use the amplifier connected to the broadband loop, and then we connect the signal generator to a small transmitting loop so that we can in this way provide some input signal to the amplifier. As you can see, there's currently only noise coming from the amplifier, and that is because the power supply is switched off. You see the level is at -110 dB, -105 dBm, and I will switch on the power supply. As you can see, the noise level jumps up to above -90 dBm, so we may have a bit too much gain in the amplifier, but that's to be assessed later whether that's actually a problem. You'll immediately see the various transmissions appear here on the 40 meter band, and in particular here you see the digital transmissions. Now when we switch on the signal generator, we should see a signal appear. And there it is. The signal generator is generating at -30 dBm, and it's a good old analog signal generator. So as you can see, it's still warming up, and the signal is drifting a bit. And now I can try to reduce the signal from the signal generator. It's -45 dBm. And I can take one more step to reduce the signal level. And now I've decoupled the cable from the signal generator, and the signal is still visible. And that's because the signal generator is emitting radiation that's picked up by the magnetic loop. So even with the attenuator at the lowest levels, there is still a fair amount of signal getting into the magnetic loop. So I can't use the lower levels of the signal generator. So I'm now going to increase the output level of the signal generator to see if we get any compression, and so to see what output levels this amplifier is capable of. So 10 dB up, you don't see much happening. 10 dB up, a little bit happening. We're now in -36. 10 dB up, now at -27. So it seems we are now capable to broadcast the signal into the loop using the transmission loop. We're going to go up 10 dB more. We're now -19 dBm. Can we go up 10 dB more? So now at -10 dBm. Can we go up even more? Yes, we are at 0 dBm. As you can see, the amplifier has a is capable of a fairly high output level, and because the steps of the signal generator of 10 dBm are reflected into the output signal, there's no evidence of any compression. So as long as the output levels are below -10 dBm, we can be fairly sure the compression is not happening. The next step is to look at the harmonics of the generated by the amplifier. And the easy thing to do is to set the center frequency of the tiny SA to the third harmonic and to look to the third harmonic. But that is not the right way to measure, because if you look at the attenuation of the tiny in the SA when I increase the signal, you see that when I go to 0 dBm, I have 25 dB attenuation, and that attenuation is needed to avoid overdriving the mixer of the tiny SA. If I now would tune the tiny SA to the third harmonic of that signal, the fundamental is no longer visible in the scan, but is still present, and it will provide a very strong signal to the mixer of the tiny SA, and it could create harmonics internally into the tiny SA. So we have to look to the attenuation, or even go to manual attenuation setting when we are observing the third harmonic. So now the first step is to see if we can center the signal a bit better. It's always difficult with such an analog generator. This seems to be better. So now we go to center 21.3. We were at 7.1. We switch off the generator to see if any signal disappears. No, there's no direct evidence of a harmonic present. So now we're going to stepwise increase the level of the signal generator and see if something appears. Here you see the signal appear that could be related to an SN harmonic. Let's try to bring it into the middle of the scan. It's still drifting a bit. It's minus 46 dBm. And I have only 0 dB attenuation. So the first thing to do is to increase the attenuation and see if that signal reduces. So go to level, attenuate, and now go to manual attenuation, and I set 10 dB attenuation, and you see that the signal level here reduces with 10 dBm, and that's because the signal is not coming from the amplifier, but is internally generated. So I'm going to increase the attenuation even a bit further. 25 dBm. And now the signal is still there, and it didn't change a lot. So now we can be sure that the harmonic is generated by the amplifier, because if I change the attenuation setting, it is minus 54 dBm, switch to 15 dBm. You see, it doesn't change anymore. So now we are sure that it is generated by the amplifier. We can now start to reduce the level from the signal generator to see when this harmonic disappears and it's no longer visible. Minus 54, 65, 75, 81. As you can see, the level of the harmonic changes together with the level of the signal generator. So it's minus 80. I move 10 dB up. Minus 76, 10 dB up. 66, 10 dB up. And 55, 54. So it moves together with the level of the signal generator. If it would be an harmonic created in the amplifier, it would, for every 10 dB that it would reduce the input signal, the harmonic would be reducing much more, because there is less drive in the amplifier and therefore less harmonic generation. So this level here probably is not generated in the amplifier, but is coming from the signal generator. So now let's have a look. Here we are at minus 75 dBm, and I'm now going to switch to the fundamental. Remember, minus 75 dBm. Going to 7.1. And here we have minus 19 dBm, let's say minus 20. So the fundamental is at minus 20 and the harmonic was at minus 75. And that means that the harmonic is at minus 55 dBc, dB versus carrier. And that's indeed the harmonic level generated by the signal generator. So even at the highest level, the amplifier does not generate additional harmonics. So it seems the amplifier behaves in a good way. And that was with an input signal that gave an output signal at minus 20 dBm. So no sign of harmonic creation internal to the amplifier. So let's now do a scan of the whole frequency range, 0 to 30 MHz, and see what type of signals are coming from the magnetic loop. Switch off the generator. And here you have the various signals. And as you can see, the strongest signals here are at the level of minus 40 dBm. You can see someone is broadcasting on the 27 MHz band, because the signal appears here. And here you have a couple of shortwave broadcast stations. So with the output levels below minus 30 dBm, I think I can be fairly safe that the amplifier of the broadband loop is not driven into compression, and it's also not contributing to harmonics in any relevant way. I hope that with this video you get some inspiration on how you can use the TinySA for various types of measurements, including assessing an amplifier.